Game K, je kan another! Dead by Daylight Killer Review, or Chapter Review, whatever you guys want to call it. I'm again joined by my co-host FalconFX.
Hi.
And by the lovely Kucho Kate.
What's up? How are you?
I'm doing good, and how are you?
Very good.
I'm glad that you are back again for this review, since you are a big fan of Capcom games, of course, like Street Fighter.
Yes.
So I'm happy that you're here to join us with the review of the long-awaited Resident Evil chapter.
Yes, and very exciting.
I'm quite impressed with what we got. And so, are you guys ready to see the killer?
Absolutely. Yeah.
Let's go.
Yeah. And the killer that we got is...
The Trapper!
No, the Almighty Nemesis.
Ooh.
And I can honestly say he looks exactly like in the game. Just exactly the same model.
Nice.
With some added extra, like the pipe here on his chest is moving and such. He has the teeth. The crooked nose. And those creepy arms. He is really a beefy boy. Personally, I had hoped that we would have gotten the original Nemesis. But we might get it as a skin, so I would be extremely happy if we get the original Nemesis as a skin. What do you guys think of how he looks?
Okay, I think we got the tallest killer in the game this time, because he's taller than Oni.
And even taller than Demogorgon.
Yeah, and also maybe taller than the Plague also. Yeah.
And she's Amazonian tall.
Yes.
She's so, very Amazonian.
Yeah, so I, this is cool, but I'm a bit afraid that it will be difficult to make mind games at loops, because since Nemesis is so tall, a survivor can easily see what are you doing.
And that is true, because the how high the killer is affects a lot the gameplay that you have as that killer. So the bigger you are, the easier you are to spot. The funny thing enough is, Freddy is the smallest killer.
Mm-hmm.
Being shorter than David King. Which is quite something. Freddy is shorter than a survivor.
But the interesting thing about Nemesis 2 is, he's basically dressed in all black.
That helps a lot.
Yeah, so when he's running around, the only thing you see is basically his pink neck and head, and that's it.
Yeah.
Kind of crazy.
It's not only that, but also because of how wide he is, you know, his big frame.
Uh-huh.
He has an easier time to body block survivors.
Yes, right.
Won't you say so, Falcon?
I only want to say that, okay, I like the model, but I would like to see a skin for Nemesis with the rocket launcher.
Who doesn't? It's kind of...
Yeah, to be honest, he's missing only a rocket launcher.
Yeah, the thing that makes him Nemesis. I mean, that is what Nemesis is all about, the rocket launcher. In Resident Evil Operation Raccoon City, he had a minigun. Even.
Mm.
And in the remake, he had a flamethrower and a rocket launcher. And in the movie, he also had a minigun. And minigun Nemesis is also really popular. So, but I personally hope we get retro Nemesis, the original one. But I would say he is, for the rest, he's perfect. They couldn't pick anyone else to fill the role as killer in this game, the Nemesis. Because he is he is basically, for all the zombies or bioweapons in the game, he is the poster boy. When you think of Resident Evil, you think of Nemesis.
Yes, definitely.
And Capcom did a lot of crossovers with Nemesis. Marvel, where he fought Spider-Man in a cutscene.
Mm.
Yeah. And he fought Mike Haggar.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Which is quite something, because that's why I say he is the most iconic, so I'm happy he is finally in the game. So, that's the only thing I can say. I'm super happy about it.
Yes.
He looks really good. And it's quite, everything moves on him.
Right, yeah.
He has all the details, all the warning signs all over his body. Caution, 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 caution. He is just
imposing.
So recognizable. You look at the distance and you can see that this is Nemesis, same as with Michael Myers.
Mm-hmm.
Who would believe that they are now sharing the same universe, those two? Michael Myers and Nemesis in the same universe. Even though we all know that Nemesis would stomp Michael Myers. if they ever face, just for the sheer feats that he has, you know. But still, it's just awesome that he is now in a game with these icons.
Yeah, so true.
I mean. It's
if you also with the ghost face.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, think about it. That says a lot about the character. If he gets to be in a game with icons like Michael Myers, Freddy Krueger, Leatherface, and Ghostface, and of course Pyramid Head, then you know that this is an iconic character. This is a cult classic character. Because he's on those levels. What do you think, Kate?
I think he looks fantastic. I can't wait to see how he's going to do when he's official.
Yeah, but what I was talking about is the fact that he's now in a game with icons like Michael Myers. This just proves that he's on the same level as them as a character, a cult classic character.
Yeah, I think it's great to try to keep things, fresh and livened up with a variety cast.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. So he's gonna bring a lot. He'll bring a lot.
So the only thing that I would have to say is Capcom, make a Nemesis movie. Give him his own movie.
Maybe.
Not that movie from Resident Evil that you guys made with Milo Jokovic, but give him his own movie, where he is the center point.
That would be interesting. An origins of Nemesis movie.
He has many in the mangas. Or the comics, he was a champion boxer.
Huh.
Yeah. And he even fought Birkin in it. And he fought five other Mr. X's.
Really?
Yeah. including a super Mr. X.
Wow, that's interesting.
And he won. That shows how powerful Nemesis is. It's just, I think Capcom should make a move. Should make a Resident Evil movie about Nemesis, where he's the villain still, like Michael Myers, but he does the same. But he's basically in the same type of role.
Right.
Chasing people, you know, he's and such. I think that is what makes Nemesis such an. That is how you should make. I think Capcom would earn a lot of money with it. With if they make a good horror movie with Nemesis.
They might, yeah, especially with you know, the steam that Resident Evil has behind it right now. It's got a lot going on for sure.
Yeah. So now that we have seen Nemesis, let's look at the crappy little survivors that we have to kill.
Yeah.
Are you ready for the survivors, Falcon?
Yeah, let's go.
Yeah.
Because this time we got two survivors.
Yeah. And the first one is, now we already see her, Jill Valentine, the master of unlocking.
Right.
And I must say, this is the new model. The completely new one.
Yeah, I played the Resident Evil 3 recently, and I can confirm it. She's exactly the copy from the Resident Evil game.
Yeah, but with one difference, and this is what I noticed, you know? They shorten her. They made her a little bit shorter. Look at the belly.
Huh.
Look at this. She did not have this in the game. In the game she was skinnier, so they made her a bit shorter for the survivor skeleton. You notice it, Falcon?
Oh, no, I didn't.
No, just look. This is dirtier. And you see a lot more wrinkles here. And she did not have that in the game. So I think they made her shorter. And of course, they noticed that she was a lot wider all of a sudden. Because she was skinnier. Jill was a lot skinnier in the Resident Evil Resident Evil 3 make. So they made her a bit... So they added this to make it look like that her clothes are more wrinkly. But they just made her shorter. You notice it? You even see it on the pants. The pants is also a bit of a different shape.
Huh. That's interesting.
Yeah, I noticed this because I'm very into details.
Right.
And that is what I really noticed, because this is a lot wider, her waist, than normal. For the rest, it is exactly like her, like the new face model and such. But it is obvious that she is that they had to shorten the model to fit more with the survivor skeleton. That is all. But for the rest, he looks great. So, what else do you have to say about her, Falcon?
I only want to say that I'm happy they decided to include this character, because I like Jill. And to be honest, I think that it was a decision also to a marketing decision, because they wanted to pick characters from different Resident Evil games.
Yeah. And Jill is always high in the popularity charts for Resident Evil characters.
Yeah. So basically, I think that Jill was pretty obvious, because they picked the Nemesis for the killer. So you pick Nemesis, you pick Jill. So yeah. It's obvious. And but we have another survivor.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. First, of course, we need Kate's opinion. What is your opinion about her?
I think she looks pretty good.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, and she, you know, she looks good, and she's wearing dark slacks and kind of a darker top, but because her arms are out and everything, you can still see her. She's still visible.
Yeah. And mm-hmm. it helps a lot that she's that you can see her, you know?
Right.
That is very needed. At least, she got an... at least we can see how she can step the killer when she has the sword strike. Look. Do you guys see it?
Yeah.
She has a knife. Her...
Yeah, she has a knife, yeah.
So, I can honestly say, at least I know it when I get the side strike, I will be like, oh yeah, she used a knife.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, think about it, the other survivors don't have anything to stab a killer with, you know? And Jill has, so Jill, I cannot be angry if I get the side strike by Jill, because she has a knife. So, yeah. All in all, this is nice. So let's go to the second one.
Mm-hmm.
And the second one is... Where are you?
Oh, just missed him.
Oh, I missed him?
Oh, I saw him.
Oh, here he is.
There he is. Yep.
Leon S. Butchin Kennedy. Okay. Also, he's a little bit compressed. Again. Because Leon is also a little bit skinny. In the games, just look at the waist. They compressed him, and with the legs also, just to make them fit the model.
Right. Yeah.
Also, if you look at his head is a little bit bigger than the model itself, and the rest of the body. So yeah, he is compressed. It's a compressed version. Basically, they actually, by the look of it, Capcom gave them the models. Which they did say in the Stranger Things livestream that companies sometimes give the CGI models or so for their characters to put in the game, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Demogorgon's model is the actual model that they use for the TV series of Stranger Things. But they had to fit it and they even had to upscale it.
Wow.
Because if they did it according to the scale how he is in the series, he would be a midget. He would be too small. So they had to scale him up. And I think they had to scale these models a little bit down so that they fit the frame of the game. But he looks really good. The only problem is he is really dark dressed, so he's hard to see. Leon is like the only non-dark skinned character that is hard to see in the game itself. What do you say, Falcon?
It is better than Jill for sure, but I still think that Claudette is way better.
Yeah, but I mean...
In hiding.
Yeah, but I mean of the people with a light skin. He is the best for hiding, right?
Maybe.
I mean, Claudette is the best one in hiding because she is dark in every area. Leon is only dark in his clothes. But not with his face and his hair, but he is like... The best selection if you want to play a lighter skin tone character or so. Because there are people that want to do that. It's the reality of the world.
Right.
Yeah, it is, but I find it cool how he looks like. He even has the butt chin. Because his chin is shaped like a butt. Which is quite... I still wonder why they didn't change that Capcom, but okay. But there are people that complain that this is not Resident Evil 4 Leon. Well, I can tell you guys this, if it was Resident Evil 4 Leon, then then he would have had really good perks.
Right.
Because Resident Evil 4 Leon is a total beast and a monster. So, yeah. They gave us the Leon that could barely handle a zombie. So, and what is your opinion about Leon S. Kennedy, Kate?
I think he, visually, I think he looks great. But the only issue I have is when you play against him.
Yeah.
From, like, the chin down. He's hard to focus on because he really kind of blends into the shadows. You really, I hate to say it, but you gotta really focus on that blonde hair of his because...
Yeah, the blonde hair and of course the big white letters on his back.
I mean, that's... I really just try to focus on his face and the top of his head.
Yeah.
Because the issue is once people start running, there's all kinds of shadowy things moving all over the place. And those little letters, you know, and his arms moving back and forth.
Yeah, that's what
it's true. Easier to try to focus on his head that's more stable. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, with Jill, you could actually see better. I mean, I mistaken one of the zombies from Nemesis, spoiler alert, as part of his power. For Jill. The female zombie, I accidentally mistaken it for Jill. So I was like, but it was the zombie, so. So that's how recognizable it was.
Yeah.
But Leon is like... Leon is like, you know. He's just dead. So, should we start with the perks? We're gonna start with the survivor perks. Are you ready, Falcon?
Yeah, let's go.
You got it ready for the tier 3s? Of course. So that we can compare it with the tier 1 and the tier 3 of the perks?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. Well, no backstory.
Very strange. Maybe they didn't complete it in time, or it's a bug.
Yeah. You know what would have been funny? You know? Really funny? Mm-hmm. If they put here, go play the game if you want to know the backstory. go play Resident Evil 2 if you want to know the backstory. That would be funny. You know, but yeah, think about it. You got a backstory here. There is nothing in here. They might as well put here. Go play Resident Evil 2 if you want to know more about Leon.
Yeah, well, they're still writing it up. They'll get it.
It's just a joke, you know.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's start. I think is his best perk.
Mm-hmm.
Here we go. Bite the bullet.
Ooh.
Pain hurts you as much as anyone, but you prefer others don't know that. You make no noise, including grunts of pain when healing. There is no noises notification on failed healing skill checks and healing regressed by only 3%. I can do this, Leon S. Kennedy. What is it with tier 3 Falcon?
It's only 1%.
1%.
Mm.
Oh. I would say that this is his best perk. At least one of his best perks. I think a lot of blended players would use this.
Yeah, do you know what I think? This is the healing version of a technician. For generators.
Yep.
Basically, it's the same perk.
Yeah. But more useful.
Yeah, of course.
Because at the end of the day, when you are using technician, and I remember that when I was fixing a generator and you were there during that round with Legion in Midwich Falcon or in Hawkins, you know, remember that?
We went the underground contest, and there was a Fang which kept the failing skill checks.
I got angry, remember?
Yeah.
I was extremely angry.
I remember you saying, Fang, please stop failing skill checks.
Yeah, or get the fuck out of here. It was... I don't get angry easily when I'm doing my... When I'm doing games with people, you know?
Mm-hmm.
As such, but... This was one of those times that... Or rare moments... recorded where I actually really got annoyed and angry.
Jeez.
And that was mostly because he kept failing it. I fixed the generator like 3 times already. So that's how many times he failed it. It was so annoying. And now we got a healing version, which actually, this is a good perk, to be honest. But like you said, it's like technician. But still, this is better than technician, right, Falcon?
Yeah, because at least it is useful. Because I think if you combo it with the Iron Will, for example, you can heal in behind the killer,
yep.
And he can't tell if you are there or not.
Yeah, this perk also counted the doctor.
Wow.
If you think about it.
And to be honest, it also counters the spirit.
Yeah, also.
Yeah.
Basically, I could see survivors using this. Anyway, Kate, what is your opinion about this perk?
Well... I mean... I can understand about the healing or the grunts of pain, but for me, the no noise on failed skill checks.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think that's a little too far. You're not biting a bullet if you fail a skill check. You just you go, oh crap, I failed a skill check. You're not in pain. You're not jumping out a window. You know, that's my opinion though.
True. But still, it is you can see that this perk is made to counter killers like Doctor, Spirit, and such.
Right.
The Doctor is like one of the killers that is high on the annoyance list of the survivors. Falcon.
Yes.
Falcon is the Doctor is on the high level of the annoyance list, right?
Yeah.
Especially when they fail skill checks with healing, and this is basically counters it.
Yeah, and also it counters the perk X Huntress Lullaby, for example.
Mm-hmm.
So okay, all in all, it's a good perk.
Yeah, it's one of the better ones. Off to the next one.
Yeah.
Flashbang. You have adapted to a world in chaos and making what you can from the debris. After completing 70% progress on any generator, Flashbang activates. Enter a locker while empty-handed and press the ability button to craft a flash grenade. One charge detonates with a loud bang and flashlight light. Creates noise notification. Can be used to distract or blind. You leave the flash grenade behind when escaping the trial. Get out of my face. Leon S. Kennedy. Okay. What do you guys think about this perk?
Okay, this is just a different version of diversion or peb, if you prefer, from the perk of Adam.
Yeah.
And okay, on tier 3 it is 50% progress.
Wow.
And to be honest, okay, it can be fun to use, but you know, against good killers it's not so effective in my opinion, because you can just look
up.
Look up, for example, or you can easily counter the perk. But anyway, the noise notification could be interesting.
Yeah, but not only that, but you will hear that the flashbang has been dropped, you know, because there is a specific sound that the flashbang makes, so you can immediately react to look up, you know.
Yeah, yeah, but if you are far from the from the point, I think that the killer can't know if it is if it was a flashbang notification or maybe a failed skill check.
Yeah, that's the only thing. And not only that, it is basically a fire cracker.
Yeah, right. To be honest, I think that this perk is better for distraction, but for blinding the killer is maybe it's only effective at rank 20 or rank 15, in my opinion, because a good killer knows how to counter the blind.
Yeah.
Just like a flashlight. So also, if you are if you are transporting a body, for example, you can just look up. It's not so it's not hard.
Yep, it is to be honest, it's one of the more balanced perks in the game.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
I mean, you have to go into a locker to make it, and so that means it slows down the game a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
But it has easy counterplay and such. It's not like you are playing against old DS and those kinds of things, like old Side Strike. Do you have an opinion about this perk, Kate? I know it is not the perk that you have experience with, of course, but what is your experience with this perk?
I think, you know, they could, if they wanted something like that, they could try to pick like a firecracker, or
basically a firecracker. Mm-hmm. Basically it is a firecracker,
right?
But you don't lose a slot,
right, or you know, if you're trying to do a distraction, maybe leap a couple of times over, you know, vault over a window a bunch of times or something. But, yeah, I think, you know, if it's to help keep things fresh and exciting, this isn't that bad. I think it's a good one.
Mm-hmm. Then we go to the next one. Rookie Spirit. You keep a careful eye on objectives when they are slipping away. Complete 5 good or great skill checks while repairing generators to activate Rookie Spirits for the remainder of the trial. Once active, you can see the aura of regressing generators. I'll stop this, Lieutenant, I promise. Leon S. Kennedy. So, to be honest, I don't see the use of this perk. It is not that good, but maybe you can. What do you think, Falcon?
I think that this is an information perk, but for example, SWF teams already have this information, because If your friend was repairing a generator and the killer kicked it, he would tell you.
Yep.
Yeah, we played together a lot of times.
Yep.
How many times I told you, I was repairing that generator, it was at 99%, and the killer kicked it, and now he's chasing me. And yeah. you went to that generator and closed it in the face of the killer.
Yeah.
Yeah, so basically it's the information perk, but not so strong, to be honest.
Only good for solo survivors.
Yeah, you also have to do something in order to activate the perk.
Yeah.
Which, it's only 3 skill checks on tier 3. But anyway, you must do something to activate the perk, and the effect is not so strong, it's just an information.
Totally agree.
Yeah, and I don't know if this perk is worth a slot.
To be honest, we already have that perk in our headset, so I don't see the point in using it. But what do you say, Kate, about this perk?
It's an interesting idea, you know, and it kind of reminds me of the opposite of what the pig perk is, where once the generators start to regress a little bit, they glow in a different color.
Yeah, surveillance.
Yeah, it's sort of the opposite of surveillance.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
It is. This, to be honest, survivors already have this perk built into the headset in Discord and such. So.
Right.
I mean, you just have to communicate with each other. It will be harder to use this perk if everyone speaks a different language and such on a headset. So. Then this perk would be good, but for the rest it doesn't. So.
Yeah, maybe I see only one situation in which this perk could be useful against maybe Hexruin.
Hexruin.
Yeah, because otherwise I don't see the point of running this perk, because also if I were repairing a generator, I know its location.
Yep.
Yeah, so I can easily go back to that generator and keep repairing it. So I don't know. I see this is only useful against Hexruin, in my opinion.
Yeah. Yeah, because then you will have time to. Then you will have.
Yeah, because in that way, since Xruin automatically regresses the generators, you can keep in mind which generators were going to pop.
Yep.
And but anyway, if you are playing in voice com, you already have this information.
Yeah, and it will most likely already be destroyed by then, the ruin.
That's right. Yeah,
ruin will be ruined. So these are the perks of Leon. So let's go to Jill Valentine. So let's go to the first perk, Counterforce. You know how to withstand an enemy stronger than you, and it starts with hunting down and knocking out their support. You cleanse totems 20% faster. After cleansing a totem, You see the aura of the furthest totem from you for 2 seconds. And you gain an additional 20% stackable speed bonus to cleanse totems for the remainder of the trial. I don't mind a little detective work. Jill Valentine. So, what do you think of this perk?
Okay, basically, bye-bye Noid.
Yeah.
Yeah. Also, consider it's 4 seconds and tier 3. And I tried this perk myself. And you can chain totems after totems. So basically, you can destroy all 5 totems in a single use of this perk.
Is there any improvements on it when it is tier 3 or not?
No, it's always 20%. So basically, okay. You find the first totem, and you have found the second, the third, and so on.
Damn.
Yeah, that's crazy. And then it's 20, 20, 20, you know? That's ridiculous. I don't know. That's my opinion.
This perk would have been meta if they didn't nerf Undying. You know that, right, Falcon?
Yeah.
This perk would have been meta if they did not nerf Undying.
Yeah, and to be honest, if they kept the old X Undying, I think that today Counterforce would be meta.
Yep.
To be honest.
100%.
But they nerfed X Undying, so okay. Now this perk is good basically for negating Noid, basically.
Yeah.
Yeah. And also, keep in mind that it is good in combo with the Inner Strength, for example.
Oh yeah, that's also true.
Yeah.
Inner Strength plus this perk and then Small Game also.
Yeah, but okay, it could be interesting in combo with the Small Game, but there is a thing. If you destroy the last totem, you don't see any aura, so you know that you destroyed the last totem.
True, but it has also more to do with the fact that you don't know what if your teammates is doing totems.
Maybe that is the only situation in which using it in combo with the Small Game is okay.
That is why I'm saying it. If you do it in combination with Small Game and such, you know, you can you can basically gauge on it or judge how good your team is if they are cleansing totems themselves also.
Yeah.
I mean, you need to look at it from the perspectives of someone that you know, that plays a lot of multiplayer games like Overwatch and such. You know, if I'm the tank in Overwatch, I notice if my damage dealers are doing damage, yes or no. I can notice if they are healing, yes or no, you know? And the problem in that Bedaled is you don't know if anyone is doing totems, you don't know if anyone is doing generators.
Yeah. And I think that for that reason they buffed the Small Game.
Yeah. Because, I will be honest, in Overwatch I get extremely frustrated when I have damage dealers that don't do damage. And I, for example, got gold damage, and I'm a tank. Even worse, I'm a melee tank, not a ranged tank, like everyone else. And I got more damage than them.
Yeah, and also, I can also tell a similar story, because many times I destroyed the 4 totems only to find that the killer is Noid.
Correct.
Yeah. Imagine you destroy 4 totems and forget just one, then the killer is Noid.
Correct. And that is why I said, in combination with small game, this is good, because then you can always have count on how many totems there are still left. Because if there are like two more totems left and you have counter force, you can try and locate the last totem as fast as possible.
Right. Which I think smart teams will make sure that they have at least one person, just one person has that on there.
Yep.
Yeah.
Especially when you are in the low ranks against killers that use know it a lot.
Right.
And
Corporal.
Yeah. To be honest, this is a good punishment for the low rank killers that rely too much on know it. Because you know the type of players that it are. They are the killers that can't mind game, that have trouble hitting someone, you know. That fall for the easy tricks in the book. Or they don't protect the generator properly, because you notice those killers, you know. Those killers are really noticeable.
Yes.
It's like, if you compare it to someone like us, you know, let's say you would see a recording of yourself from the perspective of a survivor, you know, and then that with a killer that is not experienced, you would notice the difference immediately that killer is good or if that survivor is, or if that killer is bad. You would really notice it, and you can easily say, oh, here's Noed. Because Falcon and I, we predict in terms of the playstyle of the killer, if he has most likely Noed, yes or no. And most of the time we are guessing right, correct, Falcon?
Yeah, that's correct.
So...
Yeah, because several times I told you that too many killers really on Noed to win.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And to be honest, if it was old Freddy, I would understand it. If it was old Freddy. But nowadays, I don't see any use of using Noed. Did you already have set your opinion about this perk, Kate, or do you still have to?
Oh. No, I think you guys really went over it, and I said I think it's a little, yeah. You know, I think good teams are going to have one person that's going to have that on there,
yeah.
And you know, they'll just scout, and yeah.
The dedicated totem hunter.
Right.
I already see it in front of me. Hello, I'm Claudette number three, and I'm the totem hunter of the group. Hello, I'm Claudette number four, and I'm the clicky clicky flashlighter.
Yeah.
And then all the other three Claudettes are looking at her. And one say, she's the retarded one of the group. And then, and then you see Claudette number four. Click 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 click. I wish I was good with animations, or else I would make a skit of that one. Okay, up to the next perk. Resurgence. You have come back from near impossible odds, and you do it again. Gain 40% healing progress instantly after being unhooked or unhooking yourself. It's my turn, bitch. Jill Valentine. So, what can you say about this? What can you guys say about this perk?
Okay, considering it is 50% at tier 3,
yeah.
It is good stuff, in my opinion, because it means that it halves the time that you need. For healing your friend.
Yep.
Yeah, and think about it. If you have also will make it, you can heal your friend in 4 seconds.
That's true. think about it, a survivor friends team would love this because then they can heal someone really fast and they can immediately go back on the generator.
That's right.
Yep.
Basically, this gives them. Basically, you lose more time with this perk because they will heal faster. Right,
all, I think all of the perks that they gave her could all be possibly meta perks.
Yeah.
They're all really, really good.
And to be honest, I will be really honest. You know, I thought she would have the worst perks in the game because she is the master of unlocking.
Yeah, also, and also another point. As you can see, this perk completely ignores perks which slow down the healing. So it counters Sloppy Butcher, for example.
Precisely. Precisely, because it makes Sloppy Butcher only half as effective. Because you don't have to fully heal yourself, you just have to heal yourself with 50%.
Yeah, exactly.
And that is not a lot. You're not like, oh, it takes so long or so. I mean, the only time that I get annoyed that it takes so long with when I get applied with Sloppy Butcher is if I have to fully heal myself up from 1 to 0. From 0 to 10. That is when I start to be annoyed, because at the end you're like, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. This perk is like, I would say her strongest. This is her strongest perk. Just for the sheer fact of the amount of time you can gain as a survivor. And the amount of time you will lose as a killer. Because a survivor that is healing itself is a survivor that is not working on a generator. Basically. So the longer that the survivor is healing, the longer they are not on the generator, and this negates it completely. Basically, you get unhooked, you heal yourself up, and you're immediately back on the generator again. No time wasted. Right, guys?
Yeah.
Do you have to say something about this perk, Kate?
You know, I'm noticing that a lot of the perks are counters to perks that killers basically need to use.
Yeah.
And some of them are strong counters.
Yep.
And for me, I'd say, you know, you go into, I mean, it says 40% healing process instantly after being unhooked or unhooking yourself. I
50%
mean,
at tier 3.
At tier 3, okay.
50.
But still, oh, 50%.
At tier 3.
You know, my thing is this. Isn't it, as a team, the survivor's jobs to unhook somebody?
Yes.
So why, on top of performing your task of just playing the game, are we going to reward you in addition, giving you 40-50%?
Yeah. After,
what's the point?
After being on the hook and then getting unhooked, and you get 50% healing already done.
Right. And why, you know, if I have deliverance and I unhook somebody and then I get an automatic unhook for myself and I get hooked up there and I decide to unhook myself, why after doing that should I get an automatic 40-50% of healing just for picking deliverance? You know?
Yeah. Just remove a lot of bit of skill that you should have. Yeah.
I mean, and in my mind, there's always an equation, a balance equation. Well, what's to balance this? Maybe instead of, you know, I lost it.
You got so frustrated that you forgot about it.
I got worked up. No, yeah. My computer said I got disconnected for a second. I was like, oh my god.
You should make a program on your Twitch stream, Kate, called you know what grinds my gears, and then you start Maybe. With, and then you start with, do you know what grinds my gears? This perk called Resurgence. It rewards you for getting hooked on for getting hooked.
Well, no. What I'm trying to say is that then I think the balance for that would be if there was a killer perk that said, okay, then when I'm at tier 3, when I knock somebody down, instead of having somebody struggle on the hook for 50%, they struggle on the hook for 25.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And start knocking down their hook time. Because it has to balance somewhere, in my opinion.
Yeah, there need to be a counter perk for this one.
A counter perk, right.
Yeah,
okay, basically, it means that you should do something to gain the benefit of this perk.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Basically, you get this benefit for being hooked. Basically, you make a mistake, you get hooked, and you get like 50% healing back when you get unhooked. So it's quite something, you know.
Yeah, it is.
I mean, it's like being in a fighting game, and you get all of a sudden you get stunned or dizzy, you know. And because of that, the next move that you do does ignore defense, and it does like 200% more damage than normal.
Yeah.
Basically, it's like that. And I think that is also something that a lot of people would complain about if something like that exists. So, oh well, up to the next perk, the perk that Kate likes a lot, one of Kate's favorite perks at the moment. Blast mine. When direct combat isn't an option, you still find ways to strike back. Blast mine activates after completing a total of 66% worth of repair progress on generators. After repairing generator for at least 3 seconds, press the ability button to install a trap which stays active for 35 seconds. Effective generators will be revealed to all survivors by a yellow aura. Only one trap can be active on a generator. When a killer damages a trap generator, the trap explodes, stunning them and blinding anyone nearby. Blastmine is then deactivated. You want stars? I'll give you stars. Jill Valentine. So... Kate, give your opinion about this perk. You were very vocal about this perk on your stream last few times.
I just feel like with the last perk, there's things in the game that you should complete that are just parts of the game naturally progressing.
Mm-hmm.
And with the survivors, that's unhooking survivors and fixing generators. With killers, it's knocking down survivors and breaking generators.
Yeah.
And why should I get punished for slowing down the game and breaking the generator? To me, this is the decisive strike of generators.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I mean, you're stunned out.
Yep.
For 3 seconds. And we tested it. And they can put multiple flashbangs on a generator.
Yeah, after one is used, then the next survivor has to go, work 3 seconds on the generator, put a mine on it again, and keep going.
Yeah.
Basically, the killer has to kick 2 times the generator.
Yeah, basically, this is a soft counter to Popgas the Weasel, for example.
Yep.
Because you can gain a lot of distance because the killer must waste time kicking generator twice, basically.
Yep. And this is her strongest perk, I think. This is the strongest perk that Jill has.
Yeah, yeah. Imagine facing four Blast Knights in a match.
With four Decisive Strikes.
Man, that would be annoying.
Yeah. I mean, this is because the one thing about this perk is it has to do with its objective, and that is fixing generators. So this perk will always be up. Because of the simple fact that they are working generators. And the more you kick a generator, and the more you chase them away from the generator, when they come back, they will most likely have this up again. It is, this is a perk that will always be up.
Yeah. I think maybe there is only one counter to this perk, which is... maybe two counters, because if you use X-Ruin or Surge, for example, you can regress generators without kicking them. So basically, if you run X-Ruin, you can counter Blast Mine.
Yeah, if it is destroyed by the time that you get to use for it.
Yeah.
And we both know with Surge is... You have to be lucky that you hit multiple generators.
Right.
Sadly. I think that perk of the twins, I think that one counters it. Because it, if you kick a generator, two other generators will be regressing also. If I'm correct, Vulcan?
Yeah.
Because... that's what I'm thinking, because if you get that perk for of the twins and you would hit a generator that is not Blast Mind, then that would be able to counter Blast Mind, because you're not hitting the generator that it is placed on. But still, it doesn't hold the way that this is an extremely powerful perk. The ability to protect your generator. Because you're gonna work on the generator. The killer comes, the killer chases you away, you're gonna try kick it with your Pop Goes the Weasel.
Mm-hmm.
And another survivor that is close by sees that you get stunned, goes working on the generator for 3 seconds, plays another one on it, and the cycle continues.
Right.
Because in the end, the killer gets so frustrated, he will go after one of those survivors that has Blast Mine. You know?
Yep.
It is frustration, and I saw that, and I have seen that. When, because that was also with your stream, Kate, that you basically became bonkers from it, because it was so annoying. And as you said yourself, you will tunnel that person that has this perk. For the sheer fact that you know that he has it. You know?
Yeah.
Because I think Vulcan would do the same, right?
Yeah, of course.
I mean, I would do it. I would punish that person for using this perk. That's the same what I did with people that has a Cyber Strike. If I know that someone has the Cyber Strike and they use it on me, I don't know that person off the hook. I don't give a fuck. But if you decide to strike me, I'm gonna fuck your ass. I'm gonna break.
Yeah, that's what I said. I said, you know, if I find out who the heck has Blast Mine, I'm just gonna tunnel them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then that's it. I'm gonna waste all my time focusing on them.
Yeah.
Especially if that survivor is dead on hook.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I have a Dead Nook survivor, which just decisive striked me, and should I go for another else, another survivor?
Nope. No, because...
Yeah. I'm sorry, but... I'm not going you to escape, because...
You decided to strike me.
Yeah. You are dead on hook, so I would be stupid ignoring you.
If you guys might mind, if I quote the Iron Sheik, if you guys know the Iron Sheik from WWE, a wrestler, I'm gonna quote him. If I get the size striked by whoever or blast mined by someone, I'm gonna suplex the survivor, gonna put him in a camel clutch, break his back, fuck his ass, and make him humble till he respects me and apologizes for doing that to me. In other words, I'm gonna kill him on the hook.
Yeah, but then the problem is you're gonna waste all your time staring at him on the hook. When everybody else is going to be running free.
Yeah, but then I win. You know why? He will get annoyed by it. He will be like, why you face scam me, you piece of shit? Believe it or not, a lot of... when I get face scammed, I laugh. As the Falcon, I was laughing. Because I get face scammed by a killer and I'm like... Remember, I think that also happened sometimes when I was up against a huntress, Kate.
Mm-hmm.
Because you were laughing about it when that happened, that a huntress was face camping me. I've been face camped a lot by huntresses, just for looping them and such, and I just laughed because I find it funny. Because she's raising her hatchet, but another survivor. They are like, you are camping me, you piece of stress. I hate you, you know? Those are the hardcore survivor mains, and I'm like... I got a huntress hitting me, I got an Bubba with Insidious on, with his chainsaw arm standing in front of me, and I'm just laughing.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't take it serious, but the simple fact that if I get pissed off by someone that used Blastman on the Cyber Strike and I face camp them, well, to be honest, a lot of survivors don't like that because they will insult you for just doing that. Even if they escape, they will waste their time insulting you for it. And then basically, I consider that a win. I don't know about you guys, but I see it as a win. If they, even though they win, they will still try and insult you for a few minutes, just for face camping, right, folks?
See, yeah, right.
Yeah, you're right.
I mean, that is still a win, right? In my eyes, that's a win. That means that I did a good job as killer because they are angry at me.
Yeah, but your rank isn't going to go anywhere, and this is royally going to slow down everything.
Yeah, but I see it like this. Russian. I see it like this. My rank I can get back easily. That's not the issue. Just the simple fact that I can annoy those guys, you know, mm-hmm. for me it's already worth it. But I got a different opinion, of course. I don't know about Falcon. What is your opinion? Do you consider it a win if you annoy the survivors after they decide to strike you last mind you? And you decide to camp them or tunnel them?
Bro, anyway, it all depends also if the survivors are gen rushing you or not.
Yep.
Because, you know, if I can maybe let you escape if we are at 5 or 4 generators, maybe also 3 generators, maybe.
Yeah.
But if there is only 1 generator or 2 generators left,
yeah.
I the killer has to tunnel.
Yeah.
Because I can't get to the end game with all four survivors alive.
Yeah, but I mean Falcon, that if someone decides to strike you or annoy you, you know, or something, and you say, okay, this person deserves to be face camped, you know? And even at the end of the game, when they win, you know, and they still waste their time insulting you for camping and such, do you consider it a win or a lose? Even though you are justified to do it at that point, because you were really annoyed with that person.
To be honest, I think it depends if the survivor was toxic or not, to be honest.
Because
if you just looped the killer, maybe for four or five generators, and then he decides to face camp you basically won.
Yeah, but I mean, if they...
Yeah. It's different from the case in which the survivor was toxic, was teabagging you all the time, or was clicky-clicky with the flashlight.
That is what I'm talking about.
Case, okay, that is a rage face camping.
Yeah. And
in that case, to be honest, you deserve it.
Yeah, but I mean, if the survivor starts to rage at you at the end, you know, for doing that, do you consider it a win or a lose? If they start to rage at you for camping them, or face camping them, or tunneling them, for doing stuff like that, do you consider it a win or a lose if they react like that?
I think it would be a win situation.
Yeah, and that is what I'm saying with this. If someone uses a blastman on me just to annoy me, and decides to strike me just to annoy me, and I decide to face camp them, and they start to call me, they call me everything for the worst things in the world, you know, just for doing that, I consider that a win. Because I know that I got that means that I got on their nerves, the same way that they got on my nerves.
I think it also depends from the entire team, because
that's true.
To be honest, okay, this perk, okay, it could be annoying, but if I only get a blast mine maybe once in the match, I don't consider it a problem.
Once it's not a problem for me, but I mean multiple times, but just to annoy me.
Okay, but consider that this perk is just like add-on, for example.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so you face camp the survivor with every survivor with add-on.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, to be honest, I can understand if you are mad for the combo.
Yeah.
In that case, I can understand. Okay, but if one survivor manage to use Blast Mine once, I think it is not enough to face camp him.
No, I mean not if they are doing it once, but I mean if they are doing it multiple times just to annoy you. Actually, go out of the way to do it, that when you chase someone away, they immediately go onto the generator long enough, and then put the blast mine on it. Then you get hit by it, and then they're gonna stand in front of you and they start to teabag you. After doing that,
okay, maybe in that case it would be a bit toxic. So, okay, it's okay if you decide to face camp them, but you talked about a survivor which whose behavior was toxic.
Yeah.
The only problem with this perk and the perk of Leon's, which is the firecracker flashbang thing.
Yeah.
I would consider both these perks could, in the wrong hands, easily be used for trolling.
Yeah, but Leon's perk is not that strong. That's the Leon's perk is more balanced.
It is.
Because
but
you will see him walking around with it, and you can counter it with Franklin's demise.
Yeah, you could, but I mean, I could easily see, you know, people rushing around at endgame, having troll survivors standing right in front of the gate, and then they'll just to do it, it'll start flashbanging you in the face.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just people doing things like that, you know, yeah. instead of pulling out the flashlights, it'll be that.
That's true.
Yeah. But, you know, it is what it is.
Yeah, but I mean, with this perk, you don't know if they have it, yes or no. You can't see it.
Right. Yeah.
I mean, if you see Leon with a flashbang, you could say, oh, he has the flashbang perk. You know,
right.
And it has a counter, Friendless Demise. And most of the times, you will have Friendless Demise out. Most of the times, that perk equipped. Because if survivors have toolboxes or flashlights or medkits, you will have Friendless Demise on, correct?
Yeah, you are correct.
So flashbang is useless in that case, because you know, oh. But with this one, you don't know if they have it. And you also don't know if they have it prepared, yes or no.
Right.
It doesn't have any indications, and for all I know, is you get this one survivor that goes out of the way, or two survivors that go out of the way to keep blast mining you into craziness. To drive you crazy. That is the thing that I mean with this. Because if I notice that someone has this perk, and they are purposely willing to annoy me with it, I will face camp that person.
Yeah.
Because I will be like, okay. And it will even be like, if I notice that one person, even if it only happens one, I will turn to that person just in the case that they are going to do it again. Because I'm not in the mood to always stand there and then go and go, oh. You know, because getting stunned by it makes you lose momentum. You know? You are losing momentum because you are stunned. Understand what I mean?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. Understand what I mean, Falcon? You are losing momentum.
Yeah.
And that is the issues that I have with it also. You lose momentum. It's the same as with the Sizer Strike. If you get the Sizer Strike once, you lose all your momentum. Because the survivors can regroup again and who knows what is going to happen? It's the same with this.
Yeah, do their thing.
Yeah, and this is just a basic action that every killer does. You have to kick the generator sometimes. You cannot ignore it. Sometimes you have to do it. So.
Okay. Yeah, and also, one last thing. Maybe. Since the trap stays active for some time, I also think about it. If you want to avoid the stun, you should wait for 35 or 45 at tier 3.
Yeah.
So 45 up to 45 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
Before kicking the generator, if you want to counter the perk.
Yeah, but that is again a waste of time for the killer.
Yeah. Exactly.
I mean, there is no real counter to this perk. You either have to kick it or you have to ignore it, and then the survivors will work on it. It's a lose-lose situation with this perk. It has no, you know, you kick it, you lose momentum. You ignore it, it gets fixed. That is how it works.
Yeah.
And the worst thing is, this perk is not a one-time use. You can use it perk multiple times in one round. So I think it needs a little. Tweak. Anyway, this was the last survivor perk. Blast mine. That is Jill's strongest perk. And let's just say, Kate guaranteedly hate it. I guaranteedly I find it annoying, with the fact that and Falcon, do you find it?
Yeah.
Annoying, or what would you say?
Maybe once. Maybe it's okay. Getting four blast mines in the same match can be annoying.
Yeah.
Yeah. Can't wait to find the toxic teams abusing this perk.
Yeah. Yeah, it's gonna be a twerk festival.
Yeah, twerk festival. Oh,
yeah.
God.
I see all the Claudettes and the Kates and the Serenas running around the short shorts or hot pants, twerking every time you get stunned by blast mine.
Yeah, there's Megs.
Yeah. Yeah, but Meg is flat.
Ah.
Meg has a flat butt. She has no booty. Everything went to the top. You know? But she's a spot girl, so.
Yeah.
Anyway, these are the survivor perks, and we will soon be back for the killer perks. So, hold on, people.